Hey, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about what to do when AdMob is suspended. All right, today I want to answer a comment that came in last week from Aniket Kumar, who said, next video, talk about what to do when AdMob suspended. Now this is something I get asked probably more often than anything else. My AdMob account has been suspended, what do I do? So there's two different ways to answer this. I mean, there's two different types of AdMob suspensions. There's the app suspension where you get the email that says AdMob has stopped serving ads to your application and you've got the account suspended. Now I have had the first one quite a few times in the past, so I've got the email from AdMob saying we've stopped serving ads in your application, and they'll say, you know, for whatever reason the ad usually is because of the ad placement. So I'll have ads in a certain place, and it might be because they might be covering part of the user interface, which I didn't realize on certain types of ads, or I have an interstitial that pops up at the wrong moment, so they'll temporarily remove those. Well, I say temporarily, but the email sounds final, like they just removed it. And every single time that's happened, I have made the change and I've appealed the decision, say, hey, I made these changes. I didn't realize that I was running afoul of this, you know, so I made these changes. Can you please reevaluate it? And they do, and they've turned ads back on. Everything's fine, everything's good, even though I panic a lot in the beginning. Now, when it comes to account suspensions, I have never had that happen. I've never had my account suspended. So this is, but I've done a little bit of research on it. And usually, almost all the time, well, every single time, according to the FAQ, when an account is suspended, it has to do with invalid clicks. So, you know, they detect that there's probably some invalid clicking going on. Maybe somebody's got the app and they're just clicking their own ads, or they got somebody else's clicking their own ads. And if that happens, and again, this has never happened to me, I can only see three different options you can do. Number one, you can appeal the decision. Number two, you can set up another account. Or number three, find another ad network. So the appeal thing is, like, if your account is suspended, I could almost guarantee you it's not been done by a person, right? It's been done by a machine learning algorithm that has learned over all the different ad impressions what to look out for in terms of invalid clicks. So if they see that, if the algorithm suspects that there's invalid clicks going on within your application, they're going to shut down your account and they're not even going to warn you first, which is exactly right. They have to protect their advertisers. Now, me as an advertiser, as someone who pays for ads to advertise my other applications, I want this to happen. I want them to be protecting me, because I'm not going to pay money for somebody to do invalid clicks or to actually clicking their own applications, you know, I'm not going to pay for that, right? That's just ridiculous. So I need to make sure that if I'm paying into this system, that it's actually going to be fruitful, which is why I say everybody who makes money from ads, you should at least once run an ad campaign just to see how it works, to see how impressions, you pay for impressions or you pay for clicks or whatever, but then you see what the user experience is like for the advertiser. But if you feel that you've been, like, that algorithm was wrong and you have not been doing invalid clicks, then you should appeal it, and that appeal will go to a person and that person will look into it. And you might get rejected there too. And another thing people keep asking me about is, how do you stop people from going into your app and just clicking everything and getting your account suspended? If you look at the FAQ on the AdMob site, there actually is a section there on sabotage. If you think your AdMob account has been sabotaged by a competitor, by another app, there is an appeal form on that, and they could probably investigate that too, right? If you've done nothing wrong, then you should appeal it and you should be fine. Now, if your appeal is rejected, or if you have been doing something wrong, you have the second option, which is to create another account. And I don't know if this would work or not. Everyone keeps saying, is it okay to create multiple Google Play accounts or multiple AdMob accounts? I've never done it. I've had friends that do it, and the way they talk about it, they set up separate bank accounts and separate email addresses and everything like that. It just sounds really dodgy to me, so that's something I've never wanted to do in the past. Even with the repetitive content stuff that comes out, I've never actually done that. So I don't know if Google will be able to find out if you've done that. So if somebody out there has actually got around it that way, let us know in the comments, because, you know, I think you should get a second chance, But I think it depends on how serious the offense was the first time through. And the third option, of course, is finding another ad network, because AdMob is not the only game in town. There are other ad networks out there. You've got Facebook, you've got AppLovin, you got loads of them. You got tons of them out there. And if AdMob is going to stop serving you ads, then you have to look at other ones. One of the things about mediation that I've noticed in the past is that when I did have those temporary suspensions where they removed the ads, like, all the other mediation networks shot up, because at least ads were still being served in the application. They didn't shut down ads being served through mediation networks. They just weren't serving the AdMob ads anymore. And like I said, it was a case of just saying, hey, I didn't know that this was, I didn't realize we were running a foul thing. We've made these changes. Can you please reevaluate it? And 100% of the time for me, they turn them back on, right? It's just the way it is. You have to think about it. AdMob makes, or Google makes money when you serve ads, but they must protect the advertisers. They must make sure those advertisers are secure in the network, that they're not people trying to defraud them and everything like that. When I think about it, I think about the YouTube. So every so often I'll put out a video and it gets demonetized. So I'll get the little yellow thing on it, so saying, they've disabled ads for this video because it may violate the policy. But usually it's an algorithm that does that. And again, every time I've appealed it and said, hey, can you just please review it? And then a person goes through and they just say, okay, yeah, we've turned it back on, because they can see that I'm not doing anything dodgy in the videos. So they just switch it back on. And that algorithm, I mean, you have to understand that they can't check every single app that goes out there. They can't check every single ad impression. They have to have machine learning that does it, and the machine learning is going to make those kind of decisions. But the machine learning could be wrong. But it's also, you cannot fool the machine learning. At least that's in my opinion. So I'm sorry it's not very good news today. If your AdMob account has been suspended, the only advice I have for you is to appeal that suspension. That's the only option I could think of, or set up another account, or stop using AdMob and go with another ad network. You're lucky if Google Play is still hosting your app. So anyway, let me know what you guys think, for those of you guys out there. If you've had an account suspension and you've got around it, please put it in the comments, because there's people out there, based on all the questions that I've got, who would like to know that. And anyway, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow. Bye.